Hey, I want to edit this chain. Why can't I? It keeps bouncing around. What the hell? That's problem number one, guys, with the drum racks. I'll show you how to fix it in a second. Here's problem number two. How come the volume didn't go all the way down? What? I mean, that's not the full volume of the sample. How come it's not totally controlling it? The MIDI note's not controlling it. That's problem number two. I'm Matt from The Second Spirit. I'm going to show you how to fix these problems in the drum rack real quick. All right, so the first problem is when your chains are bouncing around, when you're trying to edit them, what's happening is you have the auto select chain on for incoming MIDI notes. So I have incoming MIDI notes from these tracks into this drum rack, and it's this little button right over here on the bottom left of the drum rack or sampler. It's called the auto select, and what it does is it auto selects chains depending on the MIDI notes coming in. So every time, especially if you got a lot of hi-hats, I always had this problem with tons of hi-hats, will always flop back to the hi-hats no matter what you select. So all you gotta do is turn off this arrow here on the bottom left, and that turns off the auto select. Now you can edit your chain however you want and it won't bounce around. So that's tip number one, guys. Auto select, turn that off, you can edit your chain. Now tip number two was the kick or whatever, hi-hats. I always had a problem with the hi-hats. The volume, the velocity of your MIDI notes not totally controlling the velocity that you want it to control. Like I would turn the hi-hats all the way up, it wouldn't be that loud. And this is the reason why. If you go to your drum rack or your sampler, it's for both. Let's say we're in kick here. Go to your chain, your sample that you want that's not controlling the volume for. And it's this little round knob over here called volume to velocity. And what you do is right now it's set at 20%. And that what that means is that 20% of the MIDI velocity is going to control the volume. It's only going to control 20% of a change. So if you want your MIDI notes to totally control that sample, the loudness of that sample, you got to turn it up to 100%. So turn that to 100% on your samples that you want. And this is the thing with a lot of pre-designed drum racks in Ableton. They have a lot of this has the velocity, volume to velocity setting down to like 20 or 35%. So your MIDI notes don't control that much velocity, kind of like a compression. But I find a lot, especially in hi-hats and stuff, that I do want to control the exact velocity of those notes. So turn that all the way up to 100. And then what you'll see is if you go to your MIDI note, you can already hear it's louder. And see, it goes all the way down now to zero. So you're totally controlling the velocity of the sample from that MIDI note. And this is particularly important, I've noticed, for hi-hats. Let's go to a hi-hat real quick. Yep, see 24%. So I wouldn't be able to control much sound with these. Watch. See, it's still up a lot. See, it doesn't really control the much sound. So if I was to go to volume velocity on the hi-hat track right here, where is it? Right here. Hi-hat short, go to volume equals velocity, turn it all the way up to 100%. Now watch. Just take these, they're gonna totally control it. See? Now you can really draw in some nice hi-hat things going on, stuff like that. You got total control over that sample velocity. And this works in the sampler too, guys. So just to recap, two things that are problems with the Ableton drum rack that you can fix right now is one, this auto select is mostly always on pre-designed drum racks. And it's gonna just select whatever is playing at that time. So it's hard to edit notes and samples. And then the other one, all you gotta do is turn that off and then you can hit and edit your sample while it's while you're playing a clip behind it. And it won't change it. The other one is if you're having a problem getting the velocity out of MIDI notes for some reason in a sampler or a drum rack, if it's not controlling the velocity all the way, you need to turn ones up, they're not going all the way down. What you need to do is go to your drum rack, find the chain that you want to affect, and then move volume equals velocity over here, knob all the way over towards velocity. And that means the MIDI velocity is going to totally to 100% control the volume of that sample. If you had it down, a lot of these drum racks are at 35 or 20%. They're not controlling much volume from that sample. The MIDI note is not controlling much. So just turn that all the way up to 100%, then you'll have full total control over your velocity of that MIDI note. Hey, thanks. Subscribe if you like this video. I document my journeys of creating music with Ableton and performing live with it. And my name is Matt from The Second Spirit. Follow me too, guys. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.